Welcome to Woggle Guides. In this guide, I'll explain how to export and back up your Gmail data and how to re-import that email data back into Gmail or another email account. And don't forget, you can click on any section below to go straight to the area of this guide that interests you the most. Please do subscribe if you like what you see, so we can let you know when new guides are published. Let's get straight into it. Maybe like me, you've seen videos on YouTube that explain how to export your Gmail data. However, not many explain how to import that data back into another Gmail or email account. In this guide, I'll explain how to both download your Google data, we'll focus on Gmail in this guide, and then how to import that data back into an email account. You might need to do this if you're creating a new Gmail account, or maybe moving jobs and want to hang on to some of your old email data. Let's start by looking at how to create an export of the emails in my Gmail account. To back up my email data, I need to be logged into my Google account and visit the Google Takeout page. See the link for this page in the description below. The Takeout page allows you to export copies of the data from any of your Google products, but in this guide, we'll focus on Gmail. Looking at the page, by default, all Google products are selected for export. We only want to download a copy of Gmail emails, however, so I'm going to choose to deselect all products, and then let's scroll down to the Gmail product section of the page. As you can see, there are lots of Google products to get through, but eventually we reach the mail section. Let's select the checkbox to indicate that we want to download a copy of our emails. Let's also take a moment just to pause on mail formats, because this is important if you want to re-import the emails back into Gmail. If we click on the multiple formats link, it opens a box that confirms that emails will be exported in the MBOX mail format. We'll talk about MBOX quite a bit in this guide. By default, all mail data is included in an export of your email information. If you want to specify which emails to export, you can choose which folders or labels to save by clicking on this link. This opens up a list of Gmail labels. To choose a specific group of these folders, uncheck the Include All Messages in Mail checkbox, and then choose the specific folders you want to add to your export. Once you're happy with your selection, click the OK button, and you can see confirmation that a number of labels have been selected. So now that we've chosen what data we want to export, we need to confirm how we want to access this data. Let's click the Next button to do that. The first option to choose is how you want to deliver the export of your mail data. If we click on the drop-down, you'll see we have a number of options. If your Google account has passed its 15GB storage limit, then I'd recommend you don't request a download link via email, unless you have an alternative non-Gmail email address, or to add the export to your Google Drive. Instead, look at exporting to one of the other storage options shown. I'm going to choose the email link option, as I can still receive emails. In this next section, we can choose to run a one-off export of the data or schedule a regular export to be run every 2 months of the next year. I want to run the backup today, so I'm going to choose the single export. The last two options ask you to specify the file type and split size for the export. Both file types shown are compressed files that reduce the size of the exported data, so it takes up less space. I'll keep this export as the more recognized .zip file. As part of the export, any larger files will be split into smaller files. If you want to limit how much this happens, then simply increase the threshold of which files should be split. Bear in mind, however, that if you change the split size to larger than 2GB, then older operating systems may have some issues extracting the mail data from the zipped file. To be safe, I'm going to keep the split size at 2GB. To create the data export, click on the Create Export button. Depending on the number of emails you have in Gmail, it can take a little while to create the export. When the export is available, you'll be sent an email to confirm. So let's open Gmail, and you'll see I've received an email confirming that my export is now available and I can download it directly to my laptop. Let's now turn to look at how we can download and restore the Gmail data back into a Gmail account. Now, Google made the odd choice to support an export of your Gmail to the MBOX file format without actually providing a way to directly re-import that file back into Gmail. There are ways to do it, however, with some workarounds, but it can be a longer process. Don't worry though, I'm going to walk you through each step in the process and explain what needs to happen at each stage. The first step is to download the Gmail export of your data. You should have received an email confirming when your export was available, so I'm going to start in Gmail and find the email confirming my data is ready to download. Clicking into that email, I'm going to click in the Download Your Files button, and you'll see that the Manage Your Export page opens. The download of your email export starts automatically. Depending on the number of emails you have in your account, this might take a little while. So if I hop into the Downloads folder on my laptop, you'll see that the data export is in a compressed file format. This will decompress the file, and as always, may take a little while depending on how large the export file is. I'm going to drag this file to my desktop, just so I can work with it a little more easily. In order to import the file, we need to download an email client that we can use to upload our Gmail export so we can read the emails. If you have one already on your laptop or PC, you can probably use that. However, I'm going to download a very light email client just to show you how to do it from scratch. I'm going to use a tool excitingly named Mozilla Thunderbird, which is a free email application. You can find that by searching for Thunderbird or going to the link in the description below. To download this app, click on the large free download button. Both Windows and Mac versions of the application are available. And depending on which system you visit the page with, that's the version that will be downloaded. Once downloaded, install the application in the usual way for your operating system. And once that's completed, let's open up the email client. So the next step is to log in to the Gmail account we want to import our emails to on the Thunderbird application. To do that, let's click on the Setup Email Account option. So this is pretty quick to do. You just need to enter your name, the full email address, and your password for your email account. The email client checks your details and automatically configures the app. To complete this process, click on the Done button. You'll see an inbox has been added to Thunderbird and that is quickly filling up with all your historical emails. To make the import process easier, we need to add an add-on to the Mozilla Emails client. An add-on just provides additional features that the tool does not have built into it. To add the add-on, I just click on the hamburger menu. That's the three lines in the top right, and a menu will appear. If I scroll down, I'm going to click on the add-ons option. A new page appears, and on that page, I'm going to search for import. And the first add-on that is returned is the neatly named ImportExportTools NG. Let's add that, and I can do that by clicking the Add to Thunderbird button. This installs and then asks you to confirm access to the email client. To confirm that, click the Add button. Thunderbird then confirms that the add-on has been successfully added to the email client. In order to activate the add-on, we need to close Mozilla Thunderbird and then restart it. So, that's all the hard work over in terms of setting up the tools for the email import. The next step is to import your email export from Gmail into the Mozilla Thunderbird tool. To do that, let's click on the local folder section. And then if I right click, you'll see one of the options is Import Export Tools NG. Let's click on that. And from the options shown, I want to choose Import MBOX file. Remember, the MBOX file format is the format that the export was delivered in by Google. A number of import options are shown, but I'm going to choose the first option to import directly. I'll click OK to proceed. A search window then opens, and you'll remember we moved the extracted file to my desktop. So if I click into the takeout folder on the desktop, and then the mail folder, the file I'm interested in is the all mail file, which as you can see is an MBOX file. If I select that and then click the open button, Thunderbird has a little think about it, but you can see that slowly the emails are being imported into the email client. This is a view of the emails that were exported from Gmail, and you can click into that view and confirm that all your expected emails are there. So there is now one final step to take to import the emails that you've just extracted from the export back into Gmail. Before we do anything, I'm going to rename the folder in which the emails are currently held, so as to keep track of it when we move it to Gmail. To do that, I just right click in the folder and choose the rename option. I'm going to call it All Gmail Emails, that held apart from the emails in my Gmail account. To add the emails back into my Gmail account, all I now need to do is click and hold the old Gmail emails folder, and I can drag that under my inbox folder in Gmail. However, you can add it to any folder, and you'll see that the old Gmail folder has been added below the inbox folder, and emails are slowly being copied into that. Let's now go into Gmail and see what the new folder looks like once we've logged in. I'm in the inbox, and if I scroll down a little, you'll see there's a new folder that's been added, called inbox/old Gmail emails. And if I click into that folder, you'll see the imported emails are displayed in the usual way and can also be moved to any other label or folder in Gmail so they can be integrated with your new Gmail account. Now, as always, it may take some time for all the emails to be added into Gmail, but once that process is completed, you can then uninstall the Mozilla Thunderbird email application. I hope you found this Woggle guide useful and learned something new. If you have, please subscribe or give a thumbs up to this guide so that other users can find it too. Thanks for watching, and do look after yourself until next time.